SCTV now begins its programming day.
That in my mind forever.
Yes, SCTV is on the air. Starring John Candy. Joe Flaherty. Eugene Levy.
Is my favorite time of year. Join me, Liberace, this Christmas Eve for a musical tribute to the holidays, where we'll have a host of celebrity guests singing a medley of your favorite songs. Oh. Elton John will be joining us.
Last looked out on the feast of Stephen. All the snow lay round about, deep, crisp, and crunchy. I'm sorry, did I say crunchy? I'm sorry, Lee.
No problem, let's just...
He was moving. Yes, you. Please, we're trying to work here.
Please don't move while Mr. Wells...
You're gonna stay there, fine. If not, get out. You're taking up valuable air.
Let's just try it again.
Sorry, Lee. Good King Wenceslas, last... Your light went out. What? Am I on one or two? Who's directing here?
There's too much talking going on.
Come on, fellas, get it together. We haven't got all day.
Let's try it again, please.
Good... Are you on? Good King Wenceslas, No, I'm sorry, Lee. No, it's not working. You don't know what I'm up against here. I wouldn't rehearse an actor in Shakespeare. The way you people work here. No, I'm sorry.
Please, Arson, please.
No. It's his fault. Him. Yes, you.
I'll fire him.
No, I'm sorry. You people are pests. No money is worth this.
Orson Welles, ladies and gentlemen. You know, Christmas is a frivolous time of year, and nobody loves frivolity more than me. So join me, please, for my big special, Christmas Eve. And I'd love to thank Luigi Specca for this. Isn't this wonderful, the Santa Claus? See you then.
this way to the party. Make sure you have your cards. You have your card on your seat. That's good. Hi, Mortimer. Don't drink too much this time. Good job. That's good. I got a card. Nice women. Good Catholic women. That's good. Good. Let me see your card. Did I see your card? There it is. That's good. Do you have a card? You said you... Where is it? I don't... If you don't have a card, you missed it. Mr. Cavallaro, hurt me. Seriously, you...
Can I have everybody's attention, please? Now, keep in mind, this is a Christmas party. I want you to enjoy yourselves, but I'm going to be coming around with the Ikigami and getting some Christmas messages from you, that kind of thing. So enjoy yourselves, and the whole thing will be kind of a video record, and it'll be available on cassette, any format. And just for a simple honorarium, you'll be able to get it. Hey, take a look-see. Here comes Tex and Ed DeBoyle.
And they're good at any text. That the boil's important. There you go. That's
come
not
on
a
down, text at the boil.
There you go. There's boil box.
Merry
galore.
Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Just divide them up among yourselves. However.
Come on down.
Hey, text, that rhythm ace isn't for sale tonight, is it?
Oh, Jerry Don. How are you doing, Jerry? No, we're not selling rhythm ace. I'm just giving away boil box, and I got a little something special for you. I'll give you later.
I get a,
Hey, just, come on, get in line.
Get in line.
How are we doing there, dear?
They're nothing without me. I'm the honcho of that group.
You're the oldest, aren't you?
Hey, let's see who we got here. How you doing? Can you tell us what the N stands for?
Neat.
On behalf of Tex and I, we would like to wish you all a Merry Xmas. And to start off the evening's entertainment, we would like to sing the auctioneer's song. Oh, bring in the hogs, walk them around. Make them walk around and bring them down the chute now. Do I have five? Give me a five. Is your $5 bid? Give me a 10, there's a 50. Do I hear a 20? Give me a $20 bid. Is there a third?
Mr. LaRue, where were you last Sunday?
I don't know, where was I, sir?
When I invite a man to christening, I expect him to show up.
Oh, what time am I supposed to be there?
Last week.
Oh, yeah, well, I'm very sorry about that. You
well,
see,
you're
was...
in my prayers, Mr. LaRue. That's as much as I can give you.
You know, Maureen, if you would let that hair down, maybe take those glasses off, you know, you might be hot stuff. LaRue! Hello, Mr. Caballero. What is going on here?
Merry Christmas. Would you like some Christmas champagne?
No, I wouldn't. Now, look, you have a television show you're supposed to be doing right now.
Oh, yes, I took the liberty of scratching that for tonight. It's a little cold outside.
Now, look, that's Johnny LaRue's street beat. It's a Christmas show. It's a special. You get out there and do it.
Between me and you, I don't think anybody watches it.
I don't care who watches it. You get out there.
It's too cold out there. Please.
Good. Maybe it'll sober you up.
All right. If that's your attitude, I'll leave. Come on, girls.
Wait, hold on, hold on. You're not taking these women with you.
What?
You get out there by yourself. Look, LaRue, it's just you, one camera, one microphone. That's the show.
Please, Mr. Caballero.
Out.
It's Christmas.
Street beef. Out.
Just one girl.
You do it or you're finished. Get out of here. Get out of here. What are you looking at? Hurry up.
Tonight, Neil Simon and Marsha Mason visit Sammy on The Sammy Maudlin Show, coming up on SCTV.
Bacon grease spatula hot cheeks.
Take off. Don't get that on me, hose head.
Come on.
What?
Go.
Oh, I'm doing a special Christmas theme today.
Yeah, go.
I'm Bob McKenzie. Welcome to the Great White North. I'm Bob McKenzie. This is my brother, Doug.
How's it going?
Okay, this is our Christmas show, eh?
Yeah.
So, like, that's our
There's
top.
Our Christmas tree.
Yeah.
And Hosehead here had the idea of just having a steel spike at the top to decorate it. We're... Zoom in on the tree.
No.
Come on,
no,
move over.
Take
up
off.
To the top.
No,
zoom
here,
up.
That's what you do with that. That was off. There. Oh, that's dude. For the top. Okay, one of our topics, eh?
Wait, zoom back over to
get
us.
Over here, eh? One of our topics was like beer nog, okay? Because we hate eggnog. And like at our family parties, everybody drinks eggnog Christmas, right? So what you do is you go to Max 7-Eleven, you get eggnog, and you empty it out like right in the tree, eh? And then you pour
that'll
beer
help
in
it
here.
Grow.
Okay, you got beer right in there, and then you get like a happy cup you can't see through. Pour it in that, walk around the party. You don't have to drink eggnog. Drink beer nog instead, okay?
There it
okay,
is.
Okay, another topic is this is beauty. Like 2 years ago, we was working in brewer's retail, eh? So, like, our owner, our boss, eh? He gave us like frozen butter balls for Christmas, eh? So like Hosehead here puts it in the trunk of the car and forgot about it, right? So like next summer, Dad was driving the car and goes, who died, eh? So like goes in the trunk.
I got one for you too.
Take off, you never did.
I do. Oh. Here it is.
It's gone, eh?
Merry Christmas, Hoser.
Oh, jeez. Wait a minute.
Same size?
Beauty. I think I know what it is. Beauty.
Beauty!
Smokes, smokes!
Thanks, just what I wanted. Oh. Gee. Okay.
Thanks a lot, eh?
Beauty.
Okay.
Okay.
So,
Oh, here's something to do with beers for Christmas. Yeah. Make it nice, eh? Hold that. And, like, for tree decorations, oh, we're out of time, eh?
Yeah, quick.
Like, hang
show
a smoke
them about
up.
The smoke.
Hang some smokes up on
that was
trees.
My idea.
Take off.
It was so.
And, like,
Listen, Hosehead, give me credit.
Oh, that's it. So,
good day.
That's our topic. Merry Christmas. Good day.
Where Fred Astaire, he steals away Bingo's singing part and then takes her away and dances with
her? Yes, yes. And then Bingo gives up on her chance of making a movie about the Holiday Inn.
And then she sings White Christmas.
And then Bingo comes back to her.
Are banana daiquiris made of real banana?
What do you call that?
The banana.
Good one.
Are planners punch made of real planners?
Listen, Jerry, why don't you get yourself a Steadicam? This thing here wobbles.
Oh, those things are too expensive, Tex. I couldn't afford one of those. And, of course, Ebenezer Scrooge Caballero would never cop one up, that's for sure.
Yeah, the fact now, well, let me tell you something, little pup. You just take a look yonder over that tree there. You'll find a present mark, G-E-R-R-Y. Come on with me.
Is that for me?
Yeah, I'll get you over there.
Well, that is fantastic. Hey, somebody take the camera off me. I want to get a shot of me and Tex and the Fred. Can you get a three shot? Widen out, Tex. This is too much. This is fantastic. Should I just open it up?
Yeah, just go right ahead.
Look at this thing. It's a Steadicam. I'm so excited. Tex, thank you very much.
Here, go ahead. Kill yourself. Knock yourself. Polynesian?
It's me. Hello, Norman. A little practical joke here.
Dr. Tongue, yeah.
I'll have a plain hot dog, please.
One plain hot dog. Okay. Coming up.
Norman, take your glasses off. I want to show you a 3D effect.
Oh.
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 Sorry. Moved on me a little quick, sorry.
What's the matter with you? Are you drunk?
One little bit.
You're drunk, aren't you?
Yes.
Yeah, you've been hitting the wall bangers again, haven't
you? How could you tell?
Get out of here.
I'm leaving.
Get out.
Look at this shot. Look at how solid this one is. Uh-oh. A little adjustment here to these gyroscopes. There we go. That's more like it. Oh! Who put this here?
Matt, are you hoping to get lucky with the crew? Maybe one of the sound boys will give you the long end of the boom?
Yep. Not that that would interest you, Schwarzenegger. You didn't like parties, Mickey. Anyway, glad you could come. What happened? Your Nautilus equipment breakdown?
Nope.
No. Bums no, Elliot.
Christmas in Kowloon. There's no snow, but no one cares.
Fire enough, buddy. I got a hidden pipe.
Yeah, me too. Okay, give me a drink to alter my body chemistry. Come on, hurry up.
Hey, what's this?
This is Kowloon Gray. It's one puff dog. Be careful, it's industrial strength. Watch it. Oh, you had too much, I think.
We're gonna get you, Tang.
That will be fine.
What'll be fine?
Tang.
What can I get you?
Hot dog.
Hey, Garmin.
How are you?
tell me something. What is that supposed to be, that how are you? Is that supposed to be funny? What is it, jocular?
It's a signature. It's a signature. Everybody's got a signature. Brando's got Brando's. Stella! That's Brando's signature. Just besides, lighten up and give me a dog, will you? It's Christmas.
Listen to me, my sweet. Come with me to the doorway to hell, sir. No one is there. And we can go behind the door, and I have an antidote for you no bigger than a monkey's tail. Come on.
Did you repeat that last part?
Which part?
Part after don't worry, my sweet.
Oh, it goes on a...
Hi, how are you? I'm doing pretty good myself.
Stay tuned for a special Christmas message from Mellonville Mayor Tommy Shanks. And now a Christmas message from His Honor, Mayor Tommy Shanks.
Hi, how are you? I'm doing pretty good myself. Well, I'm a little tired, though. Me and the missus, we went Christmas shopping today, and I tell you, we went to that new shopping mall at outside of Mellonville, the covered one. That's so if it rains, you don't get rained on, or it snows, you don't get your new shoes all salty. Well, Merry Christmas.
That was a Christmas message from Mayor Tommy Shanks. Have a happy holiday. It's the Sammy Maudlin Show, starring Sammy Maudlin. Sammy's guest tonight, Neil Simon, Marcia Mason, and economist John Kenneth Galbraith. And now, it's time for Sammy.
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane.
One moment, please.
You okay, Sam? You all right? Go down the wrong pipe here.
No, that's all right. No. It's these darn cigarettes, you know? You know, I promise you, ladies and gentlemen, I am going to quit smoking one day. I really am.
He's going to do it, too. You know he's going to do it. You know, that's a good New Year's resolution for you, Sam.
Well, tell me something. William B., I hear you're one of these last-minute Christmas shoppers. Did you get your Christmas shopping done this year?
Sam, Christmas Eve, 5 o'clock, and I'm still making up my list. Right down to the line. Sammy, could I just say something right now? Christmas has been getting a bad rap lately. People are saying, and I hear this a lot, Sam, on the street, in the newspapers, wherever, that Christmas is not the same as it used to be. What with all the people pushing and shoving and just greed, that it's lost its meaning. And Sam Maudlin, can I say something to you? That I think Christmas is as good today as it ever was, and I mean that.
I tell you, you're so right, William B. You know, being a performer in this business of ours, we feel this warmth, this love, this fellowship all year round. But you people out there only experience this stuff at Christmas. I'll tell you, this Christmas, though, is going to be the best Christmas ever. I really believe that. I really do.
He does. Come on.
Okay. All right, now, our first guests have just completed a made-for-TV Christmas movie that's going to air this Christmas Eve on SCTV. Now, he's a writer who brings a new meaning to the word prolific, and he's brought his wife along, too. Ladies and gentlemen, a big warm welcome for Neil Simon and his wife, Pamela Mason.
It's Marcia.
Yeah, that's Sammy.
No, you called me Pamela.
Oh, did I? Well, Neil, how you been?
I've been very well, Sammy, very well. We just finished our latest project. It's a Christmas movie, something I always wanted to do. It's a story about a young writer who writes a play for his wife and gives it to her as a Christmas present. It was an uplifting experience, very much like Jane Russell's Cross Your Heart Bra.
Ha ha ha! Well, Doc, you have a clip of that movie you're going to show us, right?
Yes, I do, Sammy. The name of the play is Neil Simon's Nutcracker Suite. Oh, now you laugh. Where were you on the Jane Russell line?
Well, now look, that was funny. That was a funny title.
Oh, all I said was Neil Simon's Nutcracker Suite.
Oh, Doc, you kill me. You really do.
You see, Doc, it's a funny play on words. You've had Plaza Suite and California Suite, and now what's the name of this one?
Oh, come on. Now, that's the oldest trick in the world. I'm not a fool, you know. If you think you can sit here and make me say Neil Simon's Nutcracker Suite...
Please, we're gonna just take a minute now for a commercial break. We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen. We really will. Be right back.
For years, he's delighted your ears. Now this Christmas, won't you let him freshen your air? Ladies and gentlemen, the perfect Christmas gift. Now as functional as it is traditional. Frankincense. Yes, Christmas is great, but oh, those household odors. Turkey stench? Not anymore. Frankincense, the ideal holiday gift. Drat that cat. What will your Yuletide visitors think? With frankincense, smelly cat odors disappear. Say goodbye to stale cigar smoke and Uncle Howie's sneakers. No problem with frankincense. Christmas means food, but it doesn't have to mean odor. And watch your baking soda bills go way down. Yes, frankincense, $9.95, includes six assorted long-lasting aroma cones at fine stores everywhere.
Hey, hi, welcome back. Casey just joining us. Our guests are Doc Simon and his lovely wife, Pamela Mason. Now, Doc, you have a clip from that movie you want to show us, right?
Yes, I do, Sammy. I'd like to set it up, though. It's a Christmas movie, a wonderful little film, uplifting, very much like Dolly Parton's Cross Your Heart Bra. Oh, God.
Sammy, this clip is not in the movie. Our director, Herbert Ross, decided to cut it. But I thought it was one of the best scenes that Neil's ever written for me. And I wanted it to be seen.
Okay, then. Let's take a look at it right now. Now, this is a scene from Neil Simon's...
Nutcracker Suite! Damn it, what's wrong with you?
Let's take a look at it on the board.
You'll have to give me more time. I'm just not ready for this. I mean, I'm happy. I mean, it's Christmas, and I'm not alone.
Fun stuff.
Well, now, Doc, tell me something. Do you write specifically for your wife, Pamela?
Marcia!
Yes, Sammy, and that's William B. I think we all know each other.
Sammy, I write for Pamela. Marcia, I'm sorry.
Sammy, could I just say something?
Sammy, watch your cigarette, the tray! The tray, look out!
Okay, Sammy, it's fine. It's just a small fire. Stagey, can I stay in here, please?
Oh, my God! It's gonna burst me!
You've been watching The Sammy Maudlin Show on SCTV.
No problem, just a hysterical wife.
Coming up on SCTV, Neil Simon's Nutcracker Suite, starring Marsha Mason, Alan Alda, Judd Hirsch, Michael Caine, and Maggie Smith. Coming up on SCTV, Neil Simon's Nutcracker Suite.
Hey, buddy, can I have my cab back now?
Oh, sure. I don't know what it is. I'm just more comfortable behind the wheel.
Thank you, Mr. Solins. The mud is in your room. Have a nice day.
Reservation for Madison?
Madison? I'm sorry, no reservation for Madison.
No reservation?
What did I just say?
We made the booking over 6 months ago.
Who's your travel agent, Earl Scheib?
Oh, great. I can tell this vacation is going to be very uplifting, much like Jane Russell's Cross Your Heart bra.
Jane Russell's That's hysterical, Mr. I tell you what I'll do. I got one suite left. I'll let you have it for one night.
Great, I'll take it.
Fine, just sign right here.
And if you can just have a bellhop take up our bags and typewriter?
I'm sorry, there's a bellhop strike.
Oh, never mind. Just show us where the elevators are.
Oh, I'm sorry. The elevators are all broken down.
Well, I guess we'll just have to walk up.
That's suite 2611. Have a nice stay with us. Yes, Mr. Alexander. Same room as ever?
Well, this is it, 2611.
Jennifer Madison! I can't believe it, it's really you. I've seen all your films. Your last film was great. It was funny, it was witty, it was uplifting.
Uplifting? Much like Dolly Parton's Cross Your Heart Bra.
Oh, by the way, if you want room service, you better order now. We go on strike in 15 minutes.
What's with all these strikes? Is this a hotel or is it Yankee Stadium? With a lobotomy. Not a bad line.
Did you see that? Or am I the only one that's crazy around here? Something flew by here and it wasn't a 747. Okay, I got a couple of things I want to get off my chest. First of all, I don't know who you are or what you're doing here, but I don't like people barging into my hotel room uninvited. Second, as you can see, I've got a Christmas tree in here. Now, I don't know about you, but personally, I don't celebrate Christmas. I don't like putting the damn things up, and I hate like hell taking them down, taking the balls off one at a time. Third, lady, we haven't met, but you don't have to be psychic to realize there's a sexual attraction here. And in less than an hour, you're going to be passionately and desperately in love with me. Fourth, I do have some shortcomings, the least of which is my nauseating ability to babble on incessantly about myself. And if that isn't irritating enough, to do it in a voice resembling fingernails scratching across a chalkboard. And last, but quite possibly least, I have the sneaking suspicion that I am in the wrong hotel room. So, if you'll excuse me, I'll take my leave. She's crazy about me.
You meet the strangest characters in New York. Honey, what's the matter?
This is New York.
Yeah, so?
Well, you know I've always wanted to star in a Broadway play. Sure, you've written most of my movies, but you've never written me a Broadway play. Do you hate me? Is that why you brought me here? It is, isn't it?
Darling, you know how I hate scenes.
You hate scenes? Well, I love scenes. Scenes with three acts and an intermission. Do you hear that, New York? My husband has written more plays than William Shakespeare, but he refuses to write me a play.
Somebody brought you home. Just shut up. What's the problem?
No problem, just an hysterical wife.
I haven't taken my pill today.
Ah, that's it, isn't it? You forgot to take your pills. I knew there was a problem. All right, sit down, darling. Please. All right. Now, what do you want, the green ones or the blue ones?
What are the green ones?
Well, they're either very new Bennies or very old Ludes.
The Bennies or the Ludes? Oh, ones are green. I'll take a green one.
Okay, darling. Here are the green ones. Come on, darling. Now, you have a nice little nap. And when you wake up on Christmas morning, I'll have a lovely little surprise for you. Sleep tight. Now I just have to finish that script. She is gonna love this new play. Now, let's see. The writer puts his wife to bed and sits down to finish the last act. He takes a long, reflective pause, scratches his head, looks at some leaves, yawns, and falls to sleep. Midnight. What the hell's that noise? Sounds like mice. Hey, scram! Come on, beat it. Get out of there. Come on, beat it. Scram! Okay. Don't get excited. I think we can discuss this like two rational human beings. Would you care for some wine with that cheese?
Excuse me. Is this a formal party, or is it just the mice wearing tails?
The Nutcracker Suite with Alan Alda, Judd Hirsch, and Marcia Mason will continue in a moment. And now back to Neil Simon's Nutcracker Suite.
Pardon me for dropping by unexpectedly, but I've got a rendezvous with Mighty Mouse over here.
Who are you?
I'm the Nutcracker Prince. Perhaps you've heard of me?
You're a real prince?
No, I was named after my father's dog. Of course I am. Now, look, I'm not exactly the Orkin man, but I think I can get rid of this pest for you. Jake LaMotta, eat your heart out. Come on, Mickey, hit me with your best shot.
Wait. Now, look, things are getting kind of ugly here. You're the playwright. Think of something. Otherwise, you're going to lose a funny character here.
Was that the room service? No, I didn't order any cheese whiz.
Cheese whiz? Well, granted, it's not the cleverest denouement I've ever encountered, but you did save my life.
Do you mind telling me what's going on?
Look, you look like you've been working too hard. Why don't you come down to my room for a drink?
Well, all right. What room are you in?
I'm in the Nutcracker Suite. It's right down the hall. Come on.
Okay.
Teeming with great whites. If you go near there, you're crazy. They're in the shallow end, headed for the jacuzzi.
Well, here it is.
Boy, you meet the strangest snowflakes in this hotel.
Well, if you think these snowflakes are weird, wait till you get inside. What do you think? It's not much, but I call it home.
Well, you were certainly right about the snowflakes.
I thought you said you were just going out for some ice.
I say a lot of things. I'm a prince, you know. I can say whatever I want.
Darling, is that someone at the door?
Yes, it is, my sweet. But we haven't been introduced.
Your Highness, where are your manners?
Oh, I must have left them in my other suit. I know this is going to sound like a cliche, but this man just saved my life.
Don't tell me. Neil Madison, the famous playwright.
Don't tell me. The Sugar Plum Fairy.
You see, it happened again. I'll be typecast for the rest of my life.
Yeah, well, so you keep saying. Yes, my sweet. We got a marvelous relationship. She calls the shots and I pour them. Excuse me.
They make the Bickersons look like Ozzy and Harriet. Can I get you a drink?
Yeah, Coors Light.
You want that straight up or lying down?
You see, Mr. Madison, my platonic friend, the Snowflake King here, has devoted his entire life ignoring the finer points of sculpting a theatrical career.
Don't you mean your theatrical career?
Would I be speaking of anyone else's?
Exactly my point.
Touché.
If you look like a sugar plum fairy, they think all you can play is a sugar plum fairy. It's not fair. I certainly have the talent to play a sugar plum witch or a sugar plum housewife.
Or sugar plum pudding. The critics would eat, yeah. Cheers.
Look, Mr. Madison, I may be just a simple snowflake king, down a few rungs on the royal hierarchy of things, but at least I don't delude myself about what I am, which is exactly your problem, my dear. You're a sugar plum fairy, but you're the finest sugar plum fairy in all the land. And that, sir, in a nutshell, if you'll pardon the expression, is why I love her. Well, not love exactly. I mean, she is a fairy, but you get my drift.
That's it. That's the ending. That's the ending to my play.
Merry Christmas.
That'll be the phone, darling.
What? Merry Christmas.
It's a script. It's for me. It's about me. It's starring me. Oh, Neil. I'm so happy. This will be the greatest play ever produced on Broadway.
This script stinks! I wouldn't wrap fish in this thing. It's garbage. It's worse than garbage. It's the plague! I got the plague and the black plague on my desk! I gotta fumigate the damn thing just to keep it in the office! Whoa! You call this a script? What did you do, run in your sleep? You had the gall, the nerve to ask me to produce it? Me? Epi Epstein? The biggest Broadway producer in New York City? Are you insane?
Well, granted, it might need a rewrite, but didn't you find it uplifting?
Uplifting? You want to know what uplifting is? Bette Midler's Cross Your Heart Bra. That's uplifting. The hell are you laughing at? You don't even know it's funny anymore. I'll tell you something, Madison. You can't write 50 plays a year without having a clinker. Now get the hell out of my office and take this bomb with you, because it's starting to attract horseflies. Get out!
Honey, I'm sorry. I thought it was a hit.
You know what your problem is? You're a writer, but you're the best writer in all the land. And that, in a nutshell, is why I love you!
Congratulations, Mr. Madison. I hear your new play's the biggest hit on Broadway.
Thank you.
Jennifer Madison, I saw you last night at a tour de force performance.
Thank you.
Mr. Madison, you're not gonna believe what happened. Okay, Richard, take a deep breath, relax. My agent just called. I got the starring role in the film version of your new Broadway hit. First, and I don't know about you, but I am perfect for the role. When it called for a short, dumpy Jewish intellectual, I knew I had it clinched. Second, I'm sick and tired of the apartment shortage in New York, so I'm glad we're shooting on the West Coast. Now, maybe I'm a little picky, but as far as I'm concerned, what the hell?
Oh, you meet the strangest characters in New York. Taxi.
I hailed this cab.
I beg to differ, but my husband hailed this cab first, didn't you?
That's right, dearie.
Well, then why don't you say something?
All right, my wife says I hailed this cab.
Look, Mr. Steak and Kidney Pie, this is New York City, and I say I had this cab first.
And Simon says take three giant steps backward and make up your mind. I can't wait here all night.
Yeah, well, you stay out of this. You listen to me.
Hi, I'm Johnny LaRue, and welcome once again to Street Beef. Tonight's very special.
Tonight, live from downtown Mellonville, Johnny LaRue's Street Beef.
Oddly enough, deals with Christmas.
Boy, you're really good, like a wild cat. We better have a drink to alter our body chemistry.
Forget it, Lynn. You got lucky once. That was your last chance.
You don't know what is in my heart. Oh, you know, I could love you and want to marry you.
You are putting me to sleep. I have some gifts to wrap. Good night.
Strange lady. Uh-oh.
How are you?
You lay one hand on me, Biff, and I'll break your stick and cranium.
Hey, Earl, how about your Christmas message?
Oh, well, you kind of caught me off guard here. I guess I'd like to say hello and Merry Christmas to my friends here at SCTV and to the fans of SCTV News. Gee, I'm kind of at a loss for words. It's Christmas once again. I don't know what that means to you, Jerry, but to me it conjures up memories of Christmases past. I see a young boy, let's call him Earl, running home from school on the last day before Christmas vacation, the winter wind nipping at his nose, his glasses fogging up in anticipation as he runs into the house, gazing at the ornaments hanging on the family tree. I remember playing in the street and giving a cheerful wave to Mr. Stevens on the old milk wagon, Jerry, at a time when milk wagons were still pulled by horses.
Hello, hello.
Dr. French.
That's tongue.
Oh, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Did you get the lyrics for that new 3D musical I'm doing?
I sure did. I love you, you, you.
Yes, I do, do, do. You like it, huh? Will you do the movie?
Call my agent. Mm. I got a Christmas present for you, Dr. Tug.
Oh, what's that?
For the next 5 years, I'm going to bear your children.
I'll give you a $90 street code.
No.
$160.
Get your own.
You know, I'm still not sure you didn't steal my coat. You know, I don't buy that stuff with the Mormons and all those Koreans.
You're on, LaRue.
Hi, I'm Johnny LaRue, and welcome once again to Street Beef. Tonight is very special. This is Christmas Eve. And as it being Christmas Eve, the topic, of course, oddly enough, deals with Christmas. And the topic for tonight's beef is,
Don't look at me.
Commerciality in Christmas and what it means to us, the people of Mellonville. So, that's our topic. Let's talk to the people on the street and hope they air their beef tonight. But not for too long, because you freeze it off. We'll talk to anyone who comes up to us tonight. Anyone. I'll talk to anyone.
Nobody this way either.
None? Okay, well then why don't we just go into some shops, warm ourselves up, and find out what the merchant of Mellonville is doing today. Follow me. Allow me to show you my town. The fashionable three-door mall, which was just recently opened by Mayor Tommy Shanks. And I guess it's closed, this lovely. So let us move on down the Red Ox Inn, formerly the Beef and Booze. We all know it. We all know there's a lot of people in there. Let's go there now.
Use your key.
I forgot my key.
Come on, LaRue, it's freezing.
They can't be closed tonight. They can't be closed tonight.
Give them the password.
They're always open. Oh, great. Great, I was dependent on it. Well, no one in there, unfortunate for us. So we have to go back to the streets. And hopefully someone will be hopping out here to talk to us about something. Ah. The distant sound of carolers winging their merry way over to us here to air their beefs.
The sound of what?
The carolers, the music, all those lovely voices.
I don't hear any carolers. What do you hear? I don't.
What do you mean, what carolers? The carolers. Listen to the carolers. Don't you hear the carolers?
You're drunk, LaRue.
Calling me drunk?
Yeah.
You calling me a drunk? I got you this job. Now get the hell off the street right now. Get the hell out. I don't need either. Get out of here, both of you. Hey, where are you going? Come back here. Hey, we'll be right back. Out of sight.
Stay tuned for more of Johnny LaRue's Street Beat live on SCTV. This is SCTV, your Christmas comedy network. To Boomtown with Love, starring the Boomtown Rats, next year on SCTV.
So that basically sums up my life. I'd just like to say that I apologize to everyone who ever met me, or knew me, or wanted to meet me. Oh, I had talent. I had talent. I had more talent in this little finger than in this little finger. Can I be candid with you folks at home? Now tell me honestly. Do you think that the Oliviers of this world, the Andy Devines of this world, do you think they had to beg for a crane shot? I think. Therefore, I am not. Can you imagine Wild Bill Hickok and Jingles begging for a crane shot? Well, I had to. I had to beg for every crane shot I ever got. I had to beg, borrow, and steal. And I got plenty and nothing, and nothing plenty for me. I got the sun in the morning and the moon at night. I love a good Negro spiritual. It's uplifting. Take him for all he was. He was a star. And he had a show called Street Beef. And he was a man. Take him for all in all. And they shall not see his like again. Ma! Ma! I can see the South Pole! Ma, we made it! We made it! I can't feel my feet. I don't have any feet, Ma. We ate the last mule yesterday. Time to call Admiral Byrd. Ground control to Admiral Byrd. Ground control. Guy. And I call you Guy, because that's your name. You know, all the years I've been doing Street Beef, all these years, and no one has asked me, said, hey, Johnny, what's your street beef, huh? What's your street beef? Oh, that these two liver lips could talk. And they can't watch. And in conclusion, Your Honor, I would like to summation with this, that I was not always drunk. No, I was a junkie. Kidding. No tracksuits on this boy. It is a far, far better thing I do than I have ever done. And it is a far, far better place I go than I have ever. Oh! Just moving along, officer. Merely looking for a contact lens, you see. Look, Esther Williams. Oh, lovely to look at, delightful to. Care to join me in making a snow angel? If you turn off the light, I'll show you the secret.
You'll need that light, Johnny.
What?
For the shot.
What shot?
Why, your crane shot.
Huh?
Merry Christmas, Johnny. Merry Christmas.
Oh, Merry Christmas, LaRue.
next on SCTV Dusty Town's Sexy Holiday Special. It's the Dusty Town Sexy Holiday Special with Dusty's special guests from TV's Solid Gold, Marcy Odette, film star Divine, and featuring the Wally Hung Trio. Now, here's the lady of the evening, that star that leads you wayward, that bell that jingles your rock, that sweet, sweet nutcracker, ladies and gentlemen, Dusty Town.
Oh, sexy holidays to you. Sexy holidays to you. May your merry bells keep ringing and your fantasies come true. May each new friend you meet bring you more body heat. May your merry bells keep ringing. Oh, sexy holidays to you.
Also my very first TV show ever. I'm so excited and I'm happy too. You know, I just love this time of year because everyone's in the mood for giving and I'm just the girl to give it to. Isn't that cute? Isn't that true? Speaking of giving, I have a very cute Christmas story for you. I hope you haven't heard this one yet. Do you all know Mr. and Mrs. Dinky?
No!
Yeah, don't! Oh my gosh. Well, it seems last Christmas, Mrs. Dinky saved up every penny she could to buy her husband that beautiful carving knife that he'd had his eye on for so long. So before Christmas dinner, just in time to carve up the juicy turkey that Mrs. Dinky had so carefully prepared, she said, let's open presents. Lo and behold, if Mr. Dinky doesn't say he forgot to buy her a Christmas present, but can he have his anyways? So what does Mrs. Dinky do? She turns Rudolph red, she tears the wrapping paper off the carving knife, and chops up her husband like a 200-pound butterball. So, of course, she was arrested, she went to court, and was sentenced to death. But just before she was taken away, the judge looked at her with disgust in his eyes, and he said, you chopped off his head. You chopped off his feet. You chopped off his arms. You chopped off his legs. How could you, Mrs. Dinky? Now I'd like to bring out a very special guest, my first guest. This girl's a dancer, and she's a dancer on a TV show called Solid Gold. And you know the special thing about her is that I used to work with her mother at Baker's Keyboard Lounge in Detroit. And if this little girl can dance anything like a red-hot mama, she's got a big career ahead of her. Ladies and gentlemen, Marcy Odette! So don't count on... Excuse me, what the hell are you doing, Wally, playing a death march? You have a lovely sense of music, but no sense of humor. Come on, let's get together. This is Christmas. This is jokes. Let's do it. Come on. Good. That's good. I'll be a homo for Christmas, so don't count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe, but no hanky-panky. Oh, the weather outside is horrid, but the fire in you are torrid. How long will last? Just don't know. So let it grow, let it grow, let it grow. You know, I had a lovely weekend with my friend Chaz at his cabin. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at my... Ricky, what the hell are you doing jumping on the punchline? You know what you guys are getting for Christmas replacements. Come on, let's go. Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens. Bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens. Brown paper packages tied up with string. What the hell do these things have to do with Christmas? Isn't that cute? Isn't that true? kissing Santa Claus underneath his big fat... Ricky! You know, you just blew my last musical joke. My last Christmas musical joke, you really did. I don't know what's wrong. But I'm going to let it lie. Instead, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to bring out my next guest. She's the goddess of the silver screen. She's made well over 3 motion pictures, most of them X-rated. Here she is, the most divine, divine! That you were the most disgusting person on the face of the earth, and when I heard that, I just had to have you on the show. Next to her, I look like an angel.
It's great being on the same stage as you, Duffy. Oh! Did I swear?
That's okay, Divine. Just enjoy yourself. You know, I swear all the time, and nobody gives. Now, bleep him later.
You know, I'm one of your biggest fans, Duffy.
Yes, I think you may be the biggest, dear.
I've been collecting your albums since I was a little boy. Isn't that cute? Isn't that true?
Yes, dear, sad but true. I understand you brought us a little something.
Yes, a little Christmas tape that I put together. A little surprise, yes. Me singing a Christmas song!
Woo! Could you roll it?
Yes, I'll roll anything for you. Woo!
Santa, bring my baby back to me. Santa, bring my baby back to me. Santa, bring my baby back to me.
Don't need a lot of presents to make my Christmas bright. I just need my baby's arms wound around me tight. Oh, Santa, hear my plea. Santa, bring my baby back to me.
Santa, bring my baby back to me.
Please make those reindeer hurry. The time is drawing near. It sure don't seem like Christmas unless my baby's here. Don't fill my sock with candy, no bright and shiny toy. You wanna make me happy and fill my heart with joy. Then Santa, hear my plea. Santa, bring my baby back to me.
Santa, bring my baby.
Tell him, Wally.
Santa, bring my baby back to me.
Yeah. It was the night before Christmas, went all through the house. I could hear something stirring. It was my husband, that louse. I screamed down the stairs, jacket back to this bed, but heard not a word from the weasel I wed. So I slipped on my house coat and stockings with care, but except for those items, my body was bare. I scoured the whole house, but my search was in vain, and visions of homicide danced through my brain. When out on the lawn there arose such a sound, I ran to the door and tore open my gown. The moon on my breast and the new fallen snow gave the luster of youth that I had long ago. When what to my baby blue eyes should appear, but a man dressed in red from his head to his rear. From the leer in his eye to the hump in his back, I knew in a flash that it must be my Jack. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called me by name. Now, Dusty, now, Dusty, now, Dusty, please, Dusty. Now, Dusty, oh, Dusty, please, Dusty, now, Dusty. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His legs were like fir trees, his chest was so hairy. But a wink of his eye and a jerk of his head soon gave me to know I had something to dread. He stood there just smiling and rubbing his nose, so I gave him the nod, and up the staircase he rose. He sprang to the bedroom and whistled so sweet that I followed his call like a heifer in heat. And you could hear us both scream as we dove undercover. Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good lover. Isn't that cute? Isn't that true? Well, that's our show for tonight. I hope it was good for you. It sure was for me. I'd like to invite my special guests out to join me in one last Christmas so long. Divine, Marcy, bring your boys, and of course the Jewel Hall Bar, dancers and skaters.
Good evening. I'm Orson Welles, and speaking for mankind, I wish you the merriest Christmas and a happy new year.
Oh, here's what I did, Bill. I got the whole cast to renegotiate their contracts, and then I told them residuals were out for the last 4 shows.
How about that?
Hook, line, and sinker. And then I took all the 90-minute shows, I cut them up into 30-minute shows, and I sold them to Ernie Rhodes for syndication. Bill, you and I are gonna make a mint.
Jerry Todd, making a little video, were we?
That's right, Needlebum. And maybe I got some playback here that you guys might want to see.
No. Jerry, that won't be necessary, believe me.
You know, Guy, it's funny. I've been thinking about syndication myself, and I'm pretty intrigued with the concept, if you can get my drift.
Jerry, actually, Bill and I were just discussing, weren't we, Bill, the possibility of taking on a silent partner, perhaps, huh, Bill?
That's right.
What the hell are we laughing at? Todd, give me that video cassette.
Okay, Guy. Merry Christmas.
What? What is this?
Merry Christmas!
I wonder what this is. Perhaps it's a plum pudding, huh? Or maybe it's a leather-bound small volume of Keats. What the hell was that? Whoa. what it was?
Big Jim McBob and Billy Saul. Every year they blow me up, and every year I fall for it. A Yuletide Bob. I guess the joke's on me. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Christmas wouldn't be Christmas without a song from Lola Heatherton. Lola, come on out.
I love you.
Lola, why don't you go set up in front of that blue screen to do your number on chroma key, which I think is expensive and I hate.
Guy, listen, I tell you, that chroma key thing's gonna work. I'm off, the pills are gone, I've cut way down on the booze. Where the hell were you? I tell you, Guy, it's gonna work.
All right, you go over there. But you know I hate chroma key. It better work.
So what if it doesn't?
While she's setting up, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you sent a lot of money into us, because this is a holiday season and we need money. You know, it's for the needy, and we're as needy as they come. SCTV sent a lot of money. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Lola Heatherton!
Nice going. Everybody's gone.
Yeah, beauty. Whose fault is it that we're late?
Yours.
Take off.
You said we should get loaded before we come here, Holzhead.
Yeah, who knew what time beer stores open, eh?
You take off.
Take off.
They wrecked this place, eh?
Whoa.
What?
There it is, eh?
There what is?
Geez, is it on?
Yeah, it is.
Take off. There's nobody here, eh?
Oh. You sure?
Yeah. Party's over, hoser.
Sure is a tall camera.
Take off.
Boy. We worship you, O Crane.
Hey!
What?
Clean up, eh?
Take off.
You're a broom.
Cleaning it up.
Hey, let's rip off the tree.